Colin and James are back on the road, travelling the 5 miles from Bishop's Froom to Bromyard to visit what is, in many ways, Colin's own personal museum. The Time Machine Museum houses one of the biggest collections of screen-used Doctor Who props in the galaxy.
Let's go meet your fans.
My fan, singular.
They're your fans.
Their weight.
Former policeman Andy Glizzard has been collecting for 30 years.
Is it going to be bigger on the inside? No, it's smaller.
Prior to opening the museum in 1997, he kept the whole collection round at his mum's place.
I'm the owner of this exhibition,
yes,
which is approximately 80% Doctor Who, actual props and costume from the show.
How fantastic.
And the rest is made up from Star Wars, Star Trek.
What's
the Gerry Anderson?
Sorry, Star Wars.
Right, time to boldly explore some of these exhibits.
I recognise that.
Oh, yes. And this is the L1 robot, one of your infamous foes, isn't it?
It is. It's very strange because that particular robot, I was unconscious being dragged along by this thing, and my then, I suppose she was 3-year-old daughter, and she saw her daddy, who wasn't there with her, being dragged by this thing on this box in the corner. She couldn't grasp it and had nightmares for weeks.
It must have cost the BBC a fortune.
More than they were paying me.
Are you talking £25,000,
£35,000? Court, you got a lot of intergalactic megalomaniac to the pound in those days.
This is the well-known TARDIS, isn't it?
That's a very big one. I never had one as big as that.
No, I think yours was... wasn't as tall, but
nowhere
it might
near.
Have been a little bit wider.
What are you suggesting?
That was John Pertwee.
Oh, trust him to have one bigger than mine.
So lead on, Andy. Will I ever return?
The museum is an old bakery. Plenty of the fourth dimension, but not much of the first three. This tiny old place is packed to the gunnels with stuff.
Here you'll find the majority of the props and costume. You can have a look at the first exhibit, which is...
Have you seen that before? My goodness! A necktie as worn and signed by Colin Baker.
Can I have it back, please? It's mine. I did pay an awful lot of money
for
it.
No, it was stolen from me. I can attest that it's genuine, so you should have paid more for it.
The trip back in time to the days he travelled through time has put Colin in a nostalgic mood.
Late one night, after filming a Dalek story, I'd been in the bar and had a couple of drinks, and I was walking back, and I took a shortcut through the studio to my dressing room. And they'd stripped all the sets out, but there was one Dalek left in the middle of the studio floor. And it was dimly lit with emergency lighting, and as I walked past, the eye stalk followed me round. And it turned out that the operator had been worried because all day it had been squeaking, and he was inside oiling it. But I didn't know that. And for me, alone in a vast empty space with a Dalek, for a moment, just one moment, it terrified me.
But he seems to know no fear these days, stepping once more into the Dalek's lair.
You and whose army? Do you never learn?
This is their one opportunity to finally kill the Doctor.
They don't learn. How many times have I defeated them?
And they still come back for more.
Still come back for more.
He's still got what it takes. Once a Doctor, always a Doctor. So, with that time-travelling interlude, day one of the road trip is done. Night, night. I hope the Silurian bedbugs don't bite.